Hey there, YouTube family, and welcome into All About a Brand. I've done this with several different brands before, Milani, Flower, Elf, Wet n Wild. I've done this with brands before where I bring you my very favorite and show you a few duds that I don't like at all. Today I'm wearing a lot of LA Girl makeup. I'll let you know which ones I am wearing and then we will go from there. But there are some duds in here, so I want to make sure that I show those to you too. Okay, we're going to start out with the very bottom of the list. This one I could not make work. I didn't like it at all. This is their Velvet Highlight Stick. I just didn't find that that was any sort of a highlight that would really show up very much. It's very subtle, you can see right there, and I rubbed it on a lot. So the problem is in trying to get it on, if you use your fingers, you don't get very much on your fingers, and you try to dab and it disturbs your blush. Same thing with the beauty sponge. You have to layer and layer and layer, and there's so many others on the market that are so much better than this. So that one I didn't like. The LA Girl Pro Powder. This is a very finely milled powder. There's nothing against it there, but it's drying. It is so drying. There are so many other powders on the market right now that are, yes, this finely milled, but they don't dry out your skin. And this one, I felt like when I put it on, it was just too matte. It didn't really do much for my skin other than just keep me matte. So if you're really oily, that might work for you if you have a foundation that you want to wear, but it feels like it's too oily. Something like this might work for you, but I felt like it was way, way too dry. The LA Girl Pro Setting Spray. This was all right. I am wearing this today as my setting spray. But it is not my favorite because it just feels, again, like it dries me out too much. It doesn't feel like it does anything other than just, you know, put the alcohol layer on my skin. And as we all know, as we age, if we're dry, that just doesn't work very good. So this is an okay one. It's not like it's my favorite one ever, but it's not like it's the worst one ever either. The LA Girl Pro Prep High Definition Smoothing Face Primer. Okay guys, this one is a lot like the original Smashbox primer that was just kind of the dimethicone. And so it has that same properties. It's clear like that. I don't know if you can even see it. There we go. I think the light's catching it. So it's got that clearness to it. I am not into that too much because I like to have a primer that does a little bit more of everything, not just, you know, just having the dimethicone. So that one, it fell short for me. This is the LA Girl Ultimate Intense Stay Auto Liner. This one was okay. They had some pretty colors. It was a very like creamy crayon, I should say. So it had to be set down with not only other eyeshadow on top of it, but it also had to be set down with a tiny bit of just translucent powder to keep it there. So if you're looking for one that is waterproof, that's not the one either for me. This is their brow product. This is very much like the Micro Brow from NYX, the Anastasia Brow Wiz. But the color on this one really fell short. And it's kind of a very stiff product. So I'm like rubbing that a million times and it's just like barely getting on there. So this is kind of, it's a stiff product to work with, which is okay because I do set down my eyebrows with another setting gel, but I don't want to have to work that hard at it. Plus this was a very orangey color and this said soft brown. So I felt like it's very warm, not a color that worked well for me. The Volumatic Full-On Volumizing Lash Lifting Mascara. Okay, this was all right. It didn't add the volume though. It added the length and it coated all the lashes, made my lashes look longer, but it didn't give me the kind of volume that I was looking for. And I could only get about, I would say I could get about 5 hours of wear out of this and then it started to flake off. It just didn't hit all the buttons that I needed it to be like a really good mascara that I would tell you guys to run out and purchase. The next product I've been enjoying, this is their Pro Primer. This is the High Definition Eyeshadow Primer. This is very much like if you used the NYX Milk jumbo pencil. Lots of people were doing that a while ago. I don't know if you guys have been around that long or not. As far as I can tell, it's just an eyeshadow crayon that they've kind of made into a primer. As far as the longevity of my eyeshadow, I don't see that too much in using that. But I love the way that it just does that white coat. There's also, this also comes in cream So if you know you don't want white, you could have the cream. I like white because I'm pale anyway. So it did take away all of that discoloration on the top of my on my eyelids, and did a really good job about that. But as far as it being an eyeshadow primer that actually grips your primer or grips your shadow and keeps that on all day, I don't think that that's what this is for. So it does an okay job. It doesn't do a fantastic job, it does an okay job. And then there is the LA Girl Glossy Plumping Lip Gloss. I didn't feel like this was terribly plumping, but it's a pretty lip gloss, and really all it is just kind of a top clear coat. And that's kind of what I found with the other colors that I did see when I was in store. So it's a pretty gloss as far as just giving you a gloss, but as far as being clumping, I would say no on that one. Okay, so we're getting into kind of the middle things that I kind of enjoyed. This is the LA Girl Ultimate Lip Liner. This is an automatic liner. This is what I have on today actually for my lip color. And I just lined my lips, did a little bit on the outsides of it, and then I put a gloss in the middle of it. This is really a pretty color. Let's see if I can read what color it is without having to get a microscope. Enduring Mauve. I really love the color. It's really pretty. I do like it a lot. And this is one that I would say has a few colors that if you want to try different colors for the price, this is worth it. And then the Fine Line Long Lasting Fine Tip Liquid Eyeliner. Okay, I did really like this one. I have it on today, and it's just on my top lash line, and it's got a really nice point, you guys, really fine point. And the product comes out really, really easy. This is brown. I got it in because I have so many black ones, I decided to do a brown. But it really does work well. The tip isn't so stiff that you can't, you know, do the flicks that you want to, but it's fine enough that you can get straight down in that corner if that's what you like to do. So this one I have really been enjoying. And then I have the blush. This is called Just Blushing from LA Girl. This color is really pretty. It's called Just Playful. I really do like it. It's what I have on today. It's the perfect blending pairing of pink and peach, I think. It's just really gorgeous, and I really have been enjoying it. It's got a good pigment to it. It's got a good staying power. Now keep in mind that blush is usually the first thing that when I'm putting on products, it's usually the first thing that I can see that fades. So I do use a little bit more of it in the morning, and I, you know, by the end of the day, I don't feel like I'm a ghost. But this is matte, all matte, no shimmer in it whatsoever. So I do like that too, actually, because I do like to wear a different shimmer on top of my blush. But as far as it being pigmented and as far as it blending well, it did a really good job on that. Next is this mix-in. This is the LA Girl Pro Foundation Mixing In Pigment, and this is blue. Why would you ever need to put blue into your foundation? Okay, I get foundations all the time online, and when I get them home, it might be a decent foundation. I might like the lasting power. I might like the way it finishes on my face, but it turns me to orange because my undertone is neutral, leaning towards cool. So you put a drop or two of this, and I mean just a drop or two, not very much, of it into your foundation, and you don't get that orange cast on your face. And I really love that. And it's very, very pigmented. A little teeny tiny bit goes a long, long ways. I mean, I used like that much in my foundation today, and it completely changed my foundation. Now, see though, as I'm rubbing it across my hand, it's shearing out nicely. So it's not like it's going to make you look blue, like you're half dead. It's not gonna do that to you. Definitely going to help with the undertone. I know that there are a few other colors of this. I will make sure that I list it up on the screen as we're chatting here. Okay, the next thing that I found that I actually really do like these are newer to them, and they're the holographic lip toppers. I have on the pink one today. This one is the purple one. I think they're both so pretty. They give such a pretty sheen to them, and I love what both of them do. The pink one has a little bit more cast of being almost like a purpley, or being almost like a peachy pink. And then this one has a little bit of a purpley pink cast to it. So either one of these are really pretty. Since I don't have my glasses in here, I'm gonna make sure that I throw these names up. I'll do the pink one first and then the purple one so you guys can see. But yeah, I've really been enjoying that a lot as far as being lip toppers that you can put on top of any lipstick, or like just today I did a lip liner and then put that on. Really been enjoying that. So I really do enjoy the Pro Coverage High Definition Long Wearing Illuminating Foundation. I really do like that. I have it in two colors. This one, of course, is white. This one is natural. It's really a good foundation. I have it on today. I mixed these two together because this is a little bit too dark, and then I put a drop of this in it and it just became a perfect color for me. I also like the wear time on these. They're really good. They are long lasting. Even in the heat, I find that they are, but they have that little bit of luminosity to them, and I do like that too. It makes my aging skin appear to be a little bit more youthful with a little bit more of a youthful glow. I do like that about it. I've never noticed that I put it on and it oxidized. I've never noticed that I've put it on and I've seen more texture than I already have. So those are all pluses for me. It comes in a pump. This white one will last you a long time because you're just mixing it in with your regular one. I mix this in with all kinds of foundations, not just the LA Girl, and it does just great. So this is one of my top picks. Another one of my top picks are the concealers, but I'm not crazy about the actual concealer colors. I love their color correctors. Now, you guys know that I'm a Maybelline color corrector fanatic. Ever since I discovered their orange for my under eyes, I've gone crazy with it. But the peach in the LA Girl is really, really nice. It does a really great job because it's a lighter color. I also noticed that these blend out well. They do a really good job. The green is highly pigmented. So if you're gonna put that on your redness, make sure that you sheer it out very well. And if you're gonna do that on your redness, don't worry about using something like this mixing medium because you really won't need it. You already have that little bit of a cast of the on the cool tone side. They last a long time because you only need a little bit, and they also last a long time on whatever makeup look you're doing. I am wearing the peach underneath my eyes, and I just think it gives just the perfect amount of brightness, and I'm really enjoying that. I don't have to worry about, you know, the orange mix like I do when I use an orange color corrector. So I really have been enjoying using the peach, and I think I will continue to enjoy it. And last but not least, I want to tell you guys about these palettes, and I have mentioned these palettes on my channel before. So this one right here is the one that I do have on my eyes today, and it's called Vacay Every Day. And then the blue one, or the one that has blues and purples in it, is called Aloha Vibes. So let's start out with the Vacay Every Day. This is very kind of a warm, but it's got a lot of pinks in it, and it's got a lot of fun things you can do. Today I have this color right here as my transition. I have this color right here all across my lid, and then I have this one right here in my outer corner and in my crease a little bit to darken up the look. So it was a really simple look, three colors. It was no big deal, but I want to swatch these for you because not only are the metallics amazing in here, but these mattes are so soft, so buttery, so blendable. I absolutely love it. And it also has a huge mirror in there, which I use every day. I have one of these and I use it every day. They're colors that are so usable and they are so gorgeous. Now, I originally got my two palettes in Ulta, but I've never seen them since. It was like a fluke or something. And I have never seen them on Ulta's website either. Now, take a look at this one right here, which is the Aloha Vibes. Isn't that just absolutely gorgeous? The colors in this one are unique. You've got the brights and the bolds, but you've also got the purples in there, which you guys know I'm a purple lover. It doesn't matter whether you're using a matte, it doesn't matter whether you're using a shimmer, metallic, whatever's in here. They work well. I am so impressed. You barely need to touch your brush into there. Make sure you tap it off. And I really like them. They're very, very creamy and very buttery. So you do need to use a really good primer with it. I would suggest something like the NYX Proof It or the Milani eyeshadow primer. Or right now I'm really enjoying the new Anastasia Beverly Hills one. I love that. You know, there are so many palettes that are hitting the market right now, but I'm telling you guys that if you enjoy palettes, but you can't hit that money mark of $40 a palette, these are so worth it. I have just been absolutely, I reach for them all the time. They're lovely. They really truly are lovely, lovely palettes. So that is it for my review on LA Girl Cosmetics. I hope that you did enjoy it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Let me know in the comment section if there's anything that I missed, because obviously this isn't an all-inclusive review on the whole entire brand, but I definitely wanted to bring you as many things as I could to show you a little bit about the brand. And I'm sure that there are things that you've tried that you like or you don't like, and I'd like to hear that from you too. Thank you guys so much for spending part of your day with me. Please don't forget to give the video a thumbs up on your way out of here. I really do appreciate that. I hope that you all have a great day. You're the best part of my day, and I love you very much. See you in my next video. Bye-bye, guys.